everybody. Welcome to the latest episode of Radeon Rewind.
The team's been very hard at work over the past few months, launching new graphics cards, launching new software features, and of course, playing our favorite games.
That's right. And so in this episode, we're going to catch you up with everything that's happening in the world of AMD gaming, whether it's hardware or software. And so to kick us off, since last episode, we filled up the RX 7000 series product family, launching the 7600, the 7700 XT, and the 7800 XT. So Adit, why don't you tell us a little bit more about these cards?
For sure. With the introduction of these new graphics cards, the Radeon RX 7000 series spans from 1080p on the RX 7600 all the way to 4K on the 7900 XTX. Starting off with the new graphics cards, we have the RX 7600 that we launched back in May. This will be your entry point to the RX 7000 series product stack, and is focused on 1080p gaming and streaming experiences. Featuring 32 unified RDNA 3 compute units with ray tracing and AI acceleration, as well as 8GB of 18 gigabit per second VRAM, this graphics card is fantastic for checking out the hottest AAA titles, and is also a fantastic upgrade option if you're looking for a new GPU to dive into high refresh esports gaming. If we look back a few weeks ago to the end of August at Gamescom 2023, we announced the RX 7700 XT and RX 7800 XT. These graphics cards are great for 1440p gaming and streaming experiences, and when we look specifically at the 7800 XT, with 16GB of frame buffer, 60 unified RDNA 3 compute units, and DisplayPort 2.1, you actually have quite a bit of headroom to experience 4K or even high refresh 1440p ultrawide gaming when using technology such as FSR.
Okay, so that sounds awesome. How do these cards actually perform in games that we play today?
Yeah, for sure. We look at the 7000 series product family from 1080p to 4K. We can see that Radeon's actually delivering a great gaming experience, whether you're playing Starfield, Liza P, or any of the other countless games that came out over the summer. Now, as you can see, hardware wasn't the only thing we launched this summer. Isaac, I'm pretty sure that everyone wants to hear about our software updates.
That's right. This summer, we've had the amazing launch of two really great features, the first being HYPR-RX. AMD HYPR-RX brings elevated performance and reduced latency to create awesome gaming experiences for users on the newly expanded RX 7000 series product family. What HYPR-RX does is allow various features within AMD software like RSR, anti-lag, boost, and even FSR in supported games to work all together at the same time.
Let's say I'm playing hyper-tuned games like Fortnite or Dying Light 2, and I want to bring up the performance easily. All I need to do is click Enable HYPR-RX and then hop into my games.
HYPR-RX will take care of the rest to bring up my frames and lower latency, so I just need to focus on gaming. If the game I'm playing isn't hyper-tuned, HYPR-RX still works just as well. I'll click Enable HYPR-RX and launch the game, then select my lowered resolution for RSR to work or select the FSR preset of my choice. Either way, HYPR-RX works amazing across tons of games.
As Isaac mentioned, we launched two key software features this summer, with the second one being AMD FidelityFX Super Resolution 3. This is our temporal-based super resolution technology paired with AMD Fluid Motion Frames Interpolation technology. This gives you a massive boost in performance in some of your favorite titles.
There's the flexibility to play games at even higher resolutions with even better performance, or at even higher image quality with more performance, thanks to the new native AA quality mode and new frame gen technology. We're starting with support for Forspoken and Immortals of Avium, and what's even better is that the support doesn't end here. Some of our upcoming FSR 3 games will include Avatar: Frontiers of Pandora, Black Myth Wukong, Squad, Cyberpunk 2077, and many more.
I absolutely love talking about FSR 3. As someone that plays Squad every day, I can't wait for that update to get here soon enough.
You gotta double check how many hours you got on Squad, man.
Too
personally, I'm so excited for Cyberpunk 2077 to get this FSR 3 update. It's gonna look amazing.
I also can't wait for that one. Now, if you've been interested in our conversation on FSR 3, we're gonna take a much deeper dive in our next episode, so don't worry, we have you covered there. However, if you've been interested in our conversation on AMD Fluid Motion Frames, that's our frame generation technology we just mentioned, what's really cool is we have a technical preview driver that you can download from the link below, and this actually brings AFMF to the driver side, and it works across all DX11 and DX12 titles.
And what's even better is that it brings support for the RX 6000 and 7000 series graphics, so we make sure to cover you there as well.
And that concludes our episode of Radeon Rewind.
Thank you guys so much for watching. We had a great time being back, and so let us know in the comments below or hit us up on Twitter if you have any questions, what you loved, and until then, we'll see you on the next episode of Radeon Rewind.